Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today I want to talk about Apple IDs and iCloud accounts. And are they the same? Should you have multiple? Should you have one? What is the difference specifically between the two? Here we go. If you own an iPhone, iPad, or Mac, chances are you have an Apple ID. An Apple ID is Apple's way to create an account for the everyday user just like you and me so that we can access different services that they provide. Apple kind of pioneered this with iTunes and purchasing of music way long time ago, and they've just continued to add on different subscriptions nowadays, like Apple News, Apple Fitness, Apple Music, which is the new version of iTunes, iCloud, and so on and so forth. So I want to just break down really quick what an Apple ID is and what an iCloud account is and what the difference between the two are. So I have one of Apple's support articles right here that talks about Apple ID and iCloud and how you use them together. It starts off by saying use your Apple ID with iCloud. Your Apple ID is the account you use to access iCloud and other Apple services. So that is the key right there. iCloud is just one piece of the puzzle of your Apple ID, and Apple has all of these other services that require an Apple ID to be used. An Apple ID is nothing more than just an email address and a password that's associated to you that you've created. You potentially could have multiple Apple IDs, but naturally it's recommended to have one Apple ID per person. I always tell people that I work with, your Apple ID is kind of like your toothbrush. You can share it with multiple people, but I wouldn't recommend it. So don't do that. Have your own Apple ID, especially for households where you have a bunch of kids that are at the age of getting a new iPhone or an iPad, something like that. Every single individual should have their own Apple ID. I'm gonna start off by going to a website, appleid.apple.com. So I'm going to create a new tab here, type in appleid.apple.com. And this is the main website that you go to manage your Apple ID. You probably haven't been here often, but this is a place where you can go to check your privacy settings. You can check and add trusted devices for two-factor authentication. It's a lot of the background information for your account. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose sign in here. Sign in with my personal account. And notice it pops up a little message here prompting me for my password. I'm gonna use my fingerprint on my keyboard, and it's automatically gonna log me in. All right, so here I'm logged into my Apple ID on appleid.apple.com, and this is where it gives me my sign-in security, personal information, it gives me payment, family sharing, devices, and privacy. This is a really good website to know and just kind of poke around and look through if you've never done it before, because there's actually a lot of good information here. Now, this is where it can get kind of confusing, because often you want to use one account, but you might be in the instance where you have two different Apple IDs and you don't even know it. I actually have two Apple IDs that I use for different things. Actually, I have a lot of different Apple IDs because I have Learn with Joel. I have Learn with Joel Feld at iCloud.com. I have a whole bunch of different Apple IDs that I use for different testing purposes and demonstrations. But my personal life is my main email address here. But I also have another email address from very, very long ago that's associated with Apple Music and all of my payments. Here's what that looks like. I'm going to go ahead and minimize Safari. I'm going to go to the Apple on the top left and choose System Settings. On my Mac here, you'll know that in the top left, it has your Apple ID. And if I click on this first choice here, I can see that this Mac in this user account is signed in with this particular email address, which is an Apple ID. So I like to think of iCloud as your personal information. So if I click on iCloud here in the center, this is all my personal information that's associated with photos, notes, contacts, emails, calendar, reminders. It's all of the information that is personal to me. Now, if I click done here and take a step back, there's this other option for media and purchases. And if I click on this, This could be used for the App Store for buying apps on your iPhone or your iPad or your Mac. It's used for news, music, and Apple TV subscription, in addition to fitness and whatever other services Apple has. Now, if I click on Manage on the top right here, it actually takes me out of system settings and brings me over to the App Store that's on the Mac, which is equivalent to the App Store on your iPhone or iPad. And if I choose Sign In here, type in my password, it's bringing me to the account settings for all of my media and purchases. And you'll notice that this email address is different than my me.com email address. So I actually have two email addresses, two different Apple IDs, one for iCloud and one for media and purchases and everything else. In a perfect world, I would be using the same Apple ID for everything. There is no need, or I would not even recommend to have this scenario, because it's a little cumbersome and it can get confusing. You don't need it. The only reason I am still using two accounts is because there's no way to merge two Apple IDs together. All of my personal one I've been using at my me.com email address, and this Comcast email address has been associated with iTunes and music for long, long, long time ago, before iCloud was even a thing. So when I started getting into technology, I didn't realize the two different accounts. And had I known that, I would have just stuck with one account, one Apple ID that is used for everything iCloud and everything that is media, purchases, iTunes, music, TV shows, all of that good stuff. I hope that makes sense. So App Store signed into one Apple ID, and if I close out of this, go back a step, the iCloud is associated with the email address that's up here at the very top. Long story short, your iCloud account is an Apple ID. Essentially, if you're signing into any related service to Apple, if you're on apple.com buying a new computer and you're signing in with an email address and password, that is an Apple ID. So you may not even know that you have an Apple ID. So that is pretty much the difference between Apple ID and iCloud. Honestly, one of the same. Just think of it as, if you hear someone talk about an iCloud account, it is an Apple ID, and an Apple ID is really an iCloud account. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button down below. If you want to support this channel, hit that thanks button too. And if you want to learn more, hit that subscribe button, tap that little bell, and we'll see you next time.